Well, yee-haw!
God knows you.
What are you working on?
I'm working on a little project. Got a few things going on. Do you want to see?
I'd love to.
Come on in.
Thanks.
Idiot.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? Always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. Always wanted to celebrate Easter too, with you together. So let's make the most of this beautiful day and celebrate Easter together this way. And hear God's story, hear God's story, hear God's story of love for you. Hi friends, I am so glad to see you today. I'm so glad that even though we're apart, we're still together. And I have an amazing story for you today. It's a story about love and sacrifice, a story of hope, and a story that often leaves me amazed and wondering about all the things that God is up to. But it's a story you might find familiar. It's a story we've told a lot before. It's a story that makes us shout, Alleluia, Christ is risen. And we're gonna tell this story today by reading, we're gonna tell this story by playing, and we're gonna tell this story as we express our worship through art. So come, join me. Let's go tell this story. So guys, this story I want to tell you is a story that comes from the Bible, our Bible that we've been reading. But this story Brian Wildsmith wrote, he tells the story of Jesus's life, his final days, and he tells it from the perspective of a donkey. Now, each of us, as we read a story, we get our own perspective. We get to see what God is showing us in the story. So maybe you won't see it like the donkey does, but God is going to show you what he wants you to see about his story of love. Let's take a look.
Once a long time ago, a little donkey was brought to Jesus. The little donkey had never been ridden before, but Jesus spoke gently to him, and soon he stopped being afraid. Jesus climbed onto donkey's back, and they set off for Jerusalem. As Jesus and his friends drew near the city, there were great crowds standing along the road. The little donkey was amazed to see so many people. Some had spread their clothes on the road. Branches cut down from the palm trees were spread there too, all for him to walk on. By the time they reached Jerusalem, the crowds had grown more excited. Some people asked, "Who's that sitting on the back of the donkey?" Others replied, "It is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." The little donkey lifted his head proudly as they entered the city. The little donkey carried Jesus through the streets until they stopped in front of the temple. People came from all around to pray there. Jesus went inside and saw that it was like a market full of people buying and selling. Angrily, he drove them all out, shouting, "It is written, my house shall be a house of prayer, not a den of thieves." Then every day that week, he taught and healed people in the temple. The donkey stayed with Jesus in the city. Thursday was a holiday, and on that night they walked through the streets to a small house. Jesus went inside to have supper with his friends. Through the window, the little donkey saw Jesus breaking the bread. "Take and eat this," said Jesus, holding the bread. "It is my body." And the donkey watched as Jesus lifted up a cup of wine. "Take and drink this," Jesus said. "It is my blood." After supper, the little donkey followed Jesus and his friends to the Garden of Gethsemane. Jesus said to them, "Sit here and keep watch while I pray." The donkey sat and waited, but everyone else fell asleep. Suddenly, a crowd of people came into the garden. They were led by Judas, one of Jesus' friends, and they seized Jesus and dragged him away. Judas had betrayed his friend. The rest of Jesus' friends ran away. The little donkey and Simon Peter didn't run away, but followed the crowd through the city. 3 times Simon Peter was stopped. "You are a friend of Jesus," people said. Simon Peter was afraid. "No," he said, "not I." At last, they came to the house of Caiaphas, the high priest of the temple. The donkey heard Caiaphas ask Jesus, "Are you the Son of God?" "I am," Jesus replied. The high priest said, "You have heard these terrible words. How can any man speak this way of God? What do you say?" "He deserves to die." The crowd left Caiaphas' house and took Jesus to Pilate, the Roman governor, to see that he was punished. The little donkey watched as Jesus stood in front of Pilate, the chief priests from the temple, and a huge crowd of people. "Are you the king of the Jews?" asked Pilate. "Those are your words," said Jesus. The priests then accused Jesus of many things.
"Have you no answer to make to them?"
said Pilate. But Jesus didn't answer.
"What shall I do with him?" Pilate asked the crowd. "Crucify him!"
"Take him and crucify him then," said Pilate. "I wash my hands of him." So the soldiers took Jesus away. They put a crown made of thorns on his head and made fun of him.
"Hail, King of the Jews," they said.
They gave him a huge cross of wood and forced him to carry it. "If only I could help," thought the donkey sadly. But then a man came out of the crowd and helped Jesus to carry his cross. The little donkey followed as they led Jesus to a hill outside the city. And there they crucified him between 2 thieves. Late that night, a rich man named Joseph asked Pilate for the body of Jesus. He wrapped the body in a clean linen sheet. It was too heavy for him to carry. Joseph placed the body of Jesus on the donkey's back, and the little donkey carried it to a new tomb, which had been cut out of a rock. Joseph laid the body inside and rolled a huge stone in front of the entrance. Early Sunday morning, Mary, the mother of Jesus, and Mary Magdalene came to the tomb. But when they got there, they found that the stone had been rolled away, and the body of Jesus was gone. The donkey saw 2 angels where Jesus' body had been. "He's not here," the angel said. "He is alive again." Mary and Mary Magdalene left the tomb, and the donkey followed until they came into a garden. A man was standing there. It was Jesus. and the women were frightened. But Jesus said to them, "Don't be afraid. Run and tell my friends to go up to Galilee, and they will see me there." Jesus' friends were so happy to see him again. He stayed with them for 40 days, teaching them about the kingdom of God. But Jesus knew that it was near the time for him to leave this earth. And one morning, he went up to his Father in heaven.
Wasn't that an amazing story? I wonder what you found most exciting or surprising. I wonder what you found confusing. I wonder what you're going to talk to God about because of this story. So many things to think about. You know what? I'm very excited because I have some friends who love to sing and play, and, well, they got to tell this story, too. So let's go visit them and sing along. Sing along. Friends, I loved hearing Miss Abigail sing, and I loved watching my friends explore in the wilderness and imagine how to tell the story using things in the world. I've got my favorite part of the story here. This is the part where they come to the tomb and it's empty. Isn't that amazing? That That's the part of the story that makes me wonder always about God's amazing power. I wonder what part of the story you might build with things that you have at home. I have a friend, you know him too. It's Cowboy Steve, and he loves to build. He builds crosses out of wood and brick and stone and copper. And we're gonna go visit Cowboy Steve today in his workshop. Come with me.
I love Jesus. Jesus died on the cross for my sins. God loved me so much that he sent his only begotten son to die for me. This cross and other crosses remind me of the love that Jesus has for me. I spend time in this. It takes me a whole week to get it prepared. And I spend time sanding it. I clean it. I put new stain on it, and it changes colors every year. The copper color changes every year. It's not the same thing every year. Each time it changes, it's different. Well, yee-haw! Well, hello, Miss Louise.
Hey, Cowboy Steve, how are you? It's so good to see you.
Well, I am doing just fine. Welcome to my shop.
This is amazing.
I'm doing a little work today.
Can we come see?
Come on in.
Wow, Cowboy Steve, what is this? What are you working on?
Well, this cross is usually in my backyard. I keep it in the backyard, and every year I take the cross out during Holy Week, and I take it, and I sand it, and I refinish it, and I restore it every Easter. And we use this cross at church for Good Friday.
This is the cross that tells the big story of God's love. Friends, that's the story we've been telling all day. And Cowboy Steve, you tell the story in wood?
I do.
Tell me about how do you do it?
When I pray, as I sand it and work on it, I ask the Holy Spirit to come into me and to change me. Now, I do that often, but when I'm working on the cross, this is a connection I've got with Jesus that I can't even explain. It is absolutely amazing.
That sounds incredible.
And the Holy Spirit works in me as I work on it and moves my heart around. Makes me think about what I need to do differently, how I need to love God and spend time in the Bible. It clears my head and it changes me by working on this cross. Every year, and every year it's different.
That's amazing, Cowboy Steve, that because you're changing this wood, because you're showing us what this story means, you're still living out the change that Jesus makes in your heart as you work on it?
I am.
That's amazing. Hey, do you make any other crosses?
I do.
Not just out of wood, but do you have any to show us?
Yeah, can I show you a couple things?
I'd love to see them.
All right. Let me show you a couple. I'll bring them over to you. So, I made this cross out of this piece of wood. Isn't that amazing?
You changed that into that.
I did.
That reminds me, Cowboy Steve, of how Jesus changes us. Changes us not from a piece of wood into a cross, but how our hearts change, how they love God and love others more. That's the very thing you were talking about as you prayed. That's amazing, Cowboy Steve. So many crosses, so many ways to tell the story of Jesus' love for us and how not just the story transforms us, not just the wood that you create and transforms things, but it's God Himself who's at work in us, who's at work in you, transforming and changing us. That is an amazing story. And your artwork, your passion, the way you pray, that's an incredible gift of worship to the Lord. Thank you, Cowboy Steve, for sharing that with us.
You're welcome.
This has been incredible.
You are welcome. I want to show you how to make a cross on a brick.
What?
Would that be okay?
Oh, yeah, let's do
it. All right. Let's get that done.
All right.
All righty. Miss Louise, I would love you to have this cross.
That's beautiful, Cowboy Steve. Thank you so much. Thank you for this gift. Thank you for the gift of your story and how you told us how the work that you do is, it's really an act of worship, isn't it?
It is.
Oh, thank you, Cowboy Steve. I really appreciate this. And I'm going to pray when I see this and set it up where I am. Thanks for spending so much time with us today. I love seeing you.
I'd love to see you too. God bless you, Miss Louise.
Thank you, Cowboy Steve. Oh, Cowboy Steve, I love that guy.
I was so inspired by Cowboy Steve to use art to tell the story. Wasn't it amazing watching him work? Maybe you're gonna do some art today too. Sure was fun to tell the story in all those ways we did today, through the words from the Bible, through song and worship and play. So many ways to tell this very good story. Thank you for celebrating Easter with me today. Thank you for telling this really big story. I hope that you will go and tell others about God's love in this story. And in case you can't remember all the parts of the story, here's what I really want you to remember. But I'm not just gonna say it, I'm gonna sing it. God knows you, God knows you. God knows you, He created you. He's crazy about you, He's crazy about you. He's crazy about you, Jesus loves you. He goes with you, He goes with you. He goes with you, the Holy Spirit lives in you. That's it. God's great big story of His love for you. Thanks for joining us. Happy Easter, friends. I'll see you soon, and I cannot wait.